What's up, guys? Back with another one. I'm Ryan, my man George.
What's poppin', guys? How you living out there?
Las Vegas coming back at you with unbiased real reaction.
Right, shout out to our free thinkers, of course.
And our patrons.
You know it.
Another early access video.
That's right.
Eric Church. Record year.
Let's do it.
Record year.
All right. So Eric Church has been getting a lot of requests for a long time. A lot of you guys are surprised. I can't believe that you have not done Eric Church. Well, we're doing Eric Church.
Yep.
This seemed to be the biggest request. We were going, right? Right?
Yeah. Yeah, we went down the list.
Went down
the
list.
And record year seemed to have record numbers.
Record numbers. In the comment section on YouTube, what was tweeted to us, Facebook, Instagram, we'll be getting. So record year by far. I don't want to hear it.
Yeah.
It has been the biggest request. So let's get into it. Eric Church, record year.
Now, since you turned the tables on me, I've been steady learning lonely, keeping this turntable spinning. Everything from Jones to Jennings, slowly planning my survival.
Isn't it cool that we know who he's talking about? Now that we've been doing this, you know, this channel, we know who Jones, George Jones, Waylon Jennings. You know, I feel cool now. I feel, you know, like I'm on my shit. I know what's up with country now. Everything from Jones to Jennings.
Don't quiz me and shit.
Yeah.
I'm not ready for like a real country quiz yet, but we know a little something now.
Slowly planning my survival in a 3-foot stack of vinyl. Since you had to walk out of here, I've been having a record year. I bet you thought before you left, I'd just sit in silence by myself. Turn this house into a jail. Dying soul in a living hell, but.
Damn, son!
Yeah, he like, nah, I'm not sitting at home by myself.
Yeah.
So I'm about to go get it in.
So even going back, though, to that everything from Jones to Jennings slowly planning my survival in a 3-foot stack of vinyl. I thought that was dope, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you're going through things, music can help you get through
a
what you're
time.
Going through, right?
Yeah.
So I love how he referenced, you know, some country greats and said, you know, these guys helped me get through it.
Yep.
I can relate. Music helps me think and get through things as
Absolutely.
Well, man. So I like that. All right, let's get back to it, guys.
Love's got a funny way of keeping score. And you won't even lit up my scoreboard. You make it through Saturday so. Bets are off when I flip her over.
Hey!
I want scotch, I want beer. I'm having a record year. Cutting notes and Hank's half time. I'm pounding on this heart of mine. Song to song, I pass my time. These speakers on 10. You couldn't go, he's been up all night. And long songs in the key of life. I'm either gonna get old. And I'm stuck here having a record year.
Hey. Okay. What do you think about his voice, man?
Yeah, it sounds good. I really like his tone, and it sounds like country to me. But again, man, I think a lot of country singers that we've heard can really sing, dude.
Yeah,
they really can sing, man.
Yep.
You know? Now, I will be honest, all disclosure, guys, I thought this song, I'm having a record year, especially the way he started this, I thought he was going to be very, very promiscuous. I thought that's what that was going to be. Like, I'm having a record year since you left. I'm about to get out there and get it in. That's what I thought this was going. But he's actually talking
I'm
about
making records out here.
Yeah.
Smashing everything I see.
But I was pleasantly surprised.
I was disappointed. No, but seriously, quarter notes in Hank's halftime. So Hank Williams, you know, are pounding on his heart of mine. So yeah, I just love the respect that he's also showing respect to some country legends and some greats. But he's saying, you know, all bets are off when I flip her over. When I flip this record over and get to this side B, you know what I mean? That's, I think, where I'm going to find that reserve of strength.
Right,
right?
Exactly.
And get through this tough time. So I think that's what he's saying. Let's get back to it.
Save me, I'll drop it in the groove, and we go round and round and down in a spiral. I guess I'm really gonna call it thank you. I rediscover red-headed stranger, got down with old James Brown.
Hey,
found new grass revival. If you find your way back, I owe you a beer. A 4-mile record year. Quarter notes and hangs half time. A pound of notes.
Standard country song. Yeah, you know, I thought his voice was pretty standard, to be honest with you. I mean, I feel like I've kind of heard this tune, this sound a lot, you know what I mean? So it doesn't really separate itself from a lot of modern country that I've heard, but, you know, definitely doesn't sound bad. I don't know about playlists, but just standard. You know what I mean? I appreciated the him showing respect to the great legends, and I appreciated the fact that what he's saying is, in a nutshell, man, is music helps you get through some tough times, man.
Yeah, man.
Good and it's tough. Not just tough times. I mean, music is sort of, it can be the soundtrack to your life, right?
It's therapeutic.
I always say that, man. Like, music helps me remember moments, right?
Yes.
Like, these moments, and these pivotal moments in my life. Whether it's a high school dance,
yep.
Right? When it, whatever
a song takes you back,
there. Takes you right back yep. to that moment. Whether it was like when I was on vacation outside, out the country, or vacation anywhere.
You're like, oh yeah,
man. Yeah. It provides that sort of tracker.
Yes, it does.
You know what I mean? Because we don't all have diaries and shit around here. So, so what I do is I'm like, yo, what was popping in 1990? Oh, that's when this person was playing. This record was hot.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yep. It helps me understand what was going on at
that's
the time.
That's so true, man. You that's know? So true. Yeah,
but,
man.
Not playlist, but I respect it, though.
I get it, man. I thought the song was catchy as hell. I'm gonna probably saying that. I'm probably going to say that, like, a lot. I'm having a record year. I'm probably going to say that a lot, you know? And despite what I thought it was about. But I really thought that it was just catchy, man. And to your point, man, I really think the breakup allowed, the reason why, because he actually thanked her at the end of the song for the breakup, because it gave him a chance to reminisce, right? It gave him a chance to go back to songs that he loves that he probably would not have done or listened to if he was still with her.
That's right.
So that, I thought that was super cool, the way he kind of put that all into perspective. And it makes me want to go back and revisit old songs. Mm-hmm. I do, because
it
puts you in a certain mindset. It takes you, it's almost like a time-traveling machine.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying?
And you guys can watch us do it.
Right. So yeah, man, I enjoyed the song. I kind of agree with you. I don't know if it's necessarily something that you're going to play over and over and over again, but I think it's a very, very fun song. And I think he said, sound good, and I think he understands what the meaning is behind it. I think he made it with the intention that people will revisit this.
Yeah, I think that definitely know? I can see how this is played a lot.
Right.
I mean, it definitely has a significant amount of commercial appeal, I'll say that.
Right, yeah. You
know what I mean? Shout out to Eric Church, shout out to everybody who requested that one. That's the end of the video, guys. If you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. If you have subscribed, please subscribe. Las Vegas, George, Ryan.
We're out.